Cowboys. Dak Prescott is waiting to get paid like one of the elite quarterbacks in the league. Dak has led the Cowboys to the playoffs twice in his first three seasons, but he's also under a huge microscope playing in Dallas. Cowboys legend Michael Irvin gave Dak high praise when he compared him to two of the best quarterbacks of all time. Irvin said this, "People don't appreciate the charisma as a talent and gift. It's got to be the greatest talent in the business. We don't count. This is why Tom Brady has six rings. Rarely, rarely do you get the heart and soul of the football team at the quarterback position. Dak Prescott has that in him. I tell people, stop it. Stop being a dummy here. It's the ultimate gift a quarterback could have, especially in a world where the quarterback is so isolated and put on a pedestal. Aaron Rodgers should have more titles, but the problem is the dramatic and dynamic you can't win with all the time. For Dak to understand that I have to toe this line. I need to play the game steady Eddie, until I have to be the dynamic and dramatic. What he just said is why Tom Brady has six Super Bowls and Aaron has one. We're joined by four-time Pro Bowler Antonio Cromartie.
Hot today.
You know, if I like the quote, it's easy to have some power behind it.
You really just brought it to life.
Yeah, put it out there.
Brought to life.
Undebatable.
I do my best. Yeah. I mean, I do my best.
We should just go to the next topic.
You know what?
Moving on.
You don't even.
Go ahead.
Moving on.
Hand that quote.
Antonio.
Did Michael Irvin really just put him in the realm of Aaron Rodgers and Tom Brady?
No, he put him only in the Tom
Listen,
Brady.
Listen, this is what Dak Prescott is. Dak Prescott is in the realm of Jason Campbell.
He's average.
He finishes in the top 16. Right enough. Jason Campbell finished around that area right there too. Every single year. Mm-hmm. And guess what? He had a different coordinator every single year. How many coordinators has Dak had, and he still finishes around in that area?
Well, he's just on his second one now.
My point exactly.
Mm-hmm.
My point exactly.
Skip, woo, skip.
You cannot bring that in here.
We have another one. Oh, ye who are blind will be made to see.
Here we go.
You want me to go or you want to go?
I'm happy to go.
Go ahead.
I got to read to this man, another blind man.
Okay, look, I want to hear this.
What Michael Irvin said, and I love Michael Irvin because I covered him when he was a Dallas Cowboy, and he was the driving force of a team that should have won four straight, maybe five straight Super Bowls. Little issue between the owner and coach, but that's a whole nother story. But the point is, Michael Irvin was the greatest receiver lead. Rodgers didn't go a pick ahead or behind. It was right when
ahead.
Aaron.
Oh,
yeah. He went one pick ahead,
yeah,
right?
Yeah,
I thought
ahead.
So the point is, where is he now? Well, Dak Prescott's on the way to multiple Super Bowls. That's where he is because he is.
Yeah, they get tickets. Everybody get two tickets.
Yeah, he is the clutch closer of a football team that's on the verge of being not good but great. And this man has already shown you all he does is win a bunch of games because he's won the most games as a starting quarterback over the last 3 years, this side of Tom Brady. So Michael's saying it's not about Aaron Rodgers being the diva that he is because he is the drama king. He is the LeBron James of the National Football League. So Aaron, the transcendent, the greatest thrower of the football ever, he becomes a distraction. He undercuts his football team's ability to unite and ignite and go win multiple Super Bowls because he only won one. And it was about 10 years ago. Where is he now? He's struggling. He's on thin ice up on the frozen tundra. We just talked about it.
We did.
Tom Brady is the heart and soul of the New England Patriots. He's the unquestioned leader, and he's steady Eddie, through three quarters. And you say, oh, he's just mediocre. He's average. And then when the money's on the table, who closes for the Patriots the way nobody's ever closed, especially in Super Bowls? It's Tom Brady.
Yeah, everybody else done put the money up on the table because he done took the money off the table in the first three quarters.
So what did Dak Prescott do last year? He closed like crazy. I got six games. I dare you to go look at. And some of them, they didn't close because the field goal kicker clanked one in Washington off the left upright. But Detroit at Washington, at Eagles, at Falcons, Eagles again, then Seattle in the playoffs. Even the Rams, if he'd gotten the ball back, he would have closed that game.
He didn't have the ball.
Okay. Well,
he fell.
Jared Goff ran for 19 yards on 3rd and 10.
You know what, Skip Bayless? Jenny said that Dak Prescott overrated or underrated.
Mm-hmm.
What gets overrated is that he's very good. That's what's overrated. And you need to stop this. And Michael Irvin needs to stop this also, this nonsense. Y'all two cowboys. If I was
spitting truth.
They don't spit no truth.
What's truth? What's truth?
Accuracy. First of all, can we stop? Let me ask you a question. Joe Montana, was Joe Montana charismatic?
Nope. Not at all.
He won four Super Bowls, 3-0, 4-0 Super Bowl, 3-time Super Bowl MVP. So how much does charisma have to do with it, Skip?
Okay, but they had other leaders on the football team. Who was the driving force of the team? Ronnie Lott.
So that's Ronnie Lott.
That's why Michael said it's. I don't think it's rare that the leader is the quarterback.
That's my point. No. You don't necessarily have to have the quarterback to lead to be great.
Was Joe a clutch closer? Yeah.
Yeah. Hold on.
Okay.
Now you compare that to Joe Montana. You ought to stop. You know what, Skip?
I just told you he's Brady-esque. And I will Brady-esque stand by that, and you will eat that.
No, I
will.
Where is it? Where is he Brady-esque at?
Everywhere is how he plays the game.
Steady Eddie. He can't look anybody off.
He has one read.
Yes.
Okay. He finally got a number one receiver he clicked with halfway through. He goes 7-1 down the stretch. Throw your bogus stat at me. Throw it. You're lame weak. His completion percentage dropped from 42% to 40%.
Yeah.
Oh, you got me. It's game over. I got one to throw at you.
Okay. What you got?
Try this one.
Okay,
In weeks 1 through 9, Dak Prescott was tied for 28th in deep pass touchdowns.
Yes.
Tied for 28th. Yes. From week 10 on, including the postseason, as he got more and more comfortable with Amari Cooper, Dak was tied for 4th in the NFL in deep pass touchdowns. He went from 28th, week 1 through 9, to 4th, 10 on. He finally got a guy he can trust.
Where did he go to? Where did he finish at?
Where did he finish?
He went from 28th to 12th.
Fourth.
He went from 28th to 4th. Yeah. And still on the through for 22 touchdowns.
Where did he
do that?
Did they win a playoff game? Did they have a chance?
Are you just worried about winning a playoff game?
Well, no, I'm worried about winning a Super Bowl.
That ain't gonna happen. That ain't gonna happen.
And remember, he went 7-1, then he goes 8-1 against Seattle, so he goes 8-2 with Amari Cooper. And then he got an offseason to really click with Amari Cooper. You better watch out because, as Michael said, he's ready to take off.
Okay, you ready?
Okay.
Can I read something for you? You got your stat.
Go ahead.
You know, even after getting Amari Cooper, that Zeke led the Cowboys in receptions per game? Because remember, he missed the last game of the season, and he finished with one fewer catch than Amari Cooper. So, in other words, even when he got Amari Cooper, he was dinking and dunking.
He wasn't dinking and dunking. I told you over the last 8 games, he was 5th in the league in distance of completion. Is that dinking and dunking? No, he had Amari, who caught all the big balls over that stretch.
He caught slants and then turned them into big plays.
Thank you.
That didn't work.
That's not second and dunking.
Oh, wait, is that against the rules? That doesn't count.
Do they call those back? No, it's where you catch it, you're down.
No, we're talking about air travel.
You know, you're trying to be slick. Hold on, Skip. Did you know that you 8 games? That Zeke Elliott had 52 catches in 8 games?
What did I tell you yesterday? Over the first 8 with no Amari Cooper, he was the leading target receiver.
He was the leading target.
Okay, so Dak Prescott's trying to survive. They go 3-5. Was Zeke healthy the first 8 games?
Yes.
Was he happy?
Yes.
Yeah, he was healthy. Was he in Cabo? No, he was in Dallas, Texas, getting ready to play football games. They went 3-5 because Dak had nobody to throw to except his running back. I'm surprised they were even three and five.
When you have a running back like Zeke, and then they stack the line of scrimmage, they say, we're going to take Zeke away. We're not going to let, because we don't believe your quarterback can beat us throwing the football.
Mm.
And so, look, Skip, as long as you got Zeke back there, he can take that 8th guy out of the box, and now you can get single high coverage if you bring the 8th guy down in the box.
Okay, so Jason Campbell, as you call Dak Prescott, against the defending Super Bowl champ Eagles twice down the stretch, home and away, 2 fourth quarters and 1 overtime, threw for a grand total of 343 yards, 4 touchdowns, and no interceptions against the Eagles. How did he do that? You say he can't throw.
Wait a second.
He's overrated?
Did you see him on that? I think it was a Thursday night or Monday night game when they played the Tennessee Titans.
It was a debacle. I told you the next day. It was a nightmare.
I just want to make sure I'm correct.
Wait, who won the division?
Hold on, tell me. Okay, right. I'm gonna get to that. Just answer this question. Did Dak Prescott play?
Yes. Did Zeke play? Did Zeke play?
I know good and well Dak Prescott. Not Brady-esque.
Wait.
Not old Brady.
Well, Brady, every once in a while, he loses a football game. He had a couple of nightmares. He had one at Detroit. He had one at Jacksonville.
Oh, Jenny!
We're admitting it. That's good.
You know what? Newsflash, he's mortal.
No.
He is the greatest mortal ever.
No, that ain't what you told me, because when I tried to tell you, he outgunned Mahomes in the fourth quarter at overtime.
Zeke is a driving force of the Cowboys. They go as far as he takes them.
That's
they went 3-5 without Amari Cooper. And then what happened? 7-1 happened. Woo! Huh.
You ought to stop.
I think it's game over. Thank you, Michael Irvin.
I just died and went
to Cowboy Heaven. Thanks to Michael
Irvin. Those quotes were needed.
You and Michael, you ought to stop. You and Michael are both delusional.
Antonio, good stuff. Thank you for being
here today.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
We're going to talk about Kyler Murray next. Is he about to take over the NFL? We'll discuss next.